French novelist André Malraux said that man is not what he thinks he is what he hides. And you know what? I think he was onto something. Hey everyone, Laci Green here for DNews. When we're little kids, we first learn about secrets by, say, keeping a birthday present a surprise, and it's so fun! But as we age and our lives become more complicated, so do our secrets. Then secrets become not as fun, but hey, that's part of the grand disappointment that is adulthood. Maybe you secretly hate someone. Maybe you're secretly a disgusting human who does gross stuff when you're alone. Don't lie, I know you all have some nasty habits. Or maybe you have sexual secrets. Common ones being masturbating, cheating on a partner, or hiding your sexual orientation. Psychologists believe that the ability to keep small secrets is a sign of good mental health. There's a time and a place for sharing some things, you know what I mean? I'm talking about those TMI secrets. Having a secret or two about ourselves has also been shown to help us develop a sense of self outside of the crowd, which is a positive thing for our identities. But what about big secrets? Damaging secrets? Secrets that eat you from the inside out? Secrets that you hold on to, maybe for years? Scientists have found that these kind of secrets are bad news. A study in the International Journal of Behavioral Development found that young adults who admitted they were keeping a secret had lower levels of self-control, higher levels of loneliness and depression, and their personal relationships were compromised. The researchers checked back in with them 6 months later, and those who had revealed their secrets showed a dramatic improvement in symptoms. At the end of the study, they found that the women were more likely than men to have secrets and that they were also less likely to share them. Another super interesting study published in the journal Social Psychology and Personality Science found that secrets actually feel physically burdensome. You know how people talk about having baggage or feeling heavy? People in the study who were told to focus on a personal secret judged hills to be steeper and distant to be longer than they actually were, while people who were given the opportunity to tell their secret felt no such burden. So, in case you need more proof that keeping a secret feels like crap and telling someone can be the greatest relief ever, now you have it. The good news, or maybe the bad news depending on how you look at it, is that one way or another, our brains usually find a way to purge itself of distressing secrets. Harvard neuroscientist Laura Smart explains that when we try to suppress a secret, a mental process called ironic monitoring unconsciously kicks in. It surveys unwanted thoughts, eventually bringing them bubbling to the surface where they become a part of the intentional operating process, which is our conscious awareness. In other words, secrets haunt you until they're allowed to break free. So, peeps, I really care about you and I don't want you to have any nervous breakdowns. So today's comment board will be a confessional. Spill your secrets down below and walk away a healthier person. Thanks for joining me for DNews. I'll see you next time.